In this video demonstration, we will look at backing up and restoring from a virtual hard disk. We will look at configuring network backup with Windows Server, mounting a backup VHD and extracting data, and finally configuring a computer to boot from a backup VHD. So let's begin by configuring network backup with Windows Server Backup. I'm going to go in and do a new text document, and I'm just going to call this example underscore data, and from here we're just typing a message. Okay, so we've just typed in a message and we're going to go ahead and save. Now from here I'm going to go into Server Manager. I'm going to click on Features, Add Features, and I'm going to scroll all the way down and I want to select the Windows Server Backup features, and I want to make sure I do it for both the GUI and the command line. I'm going to click Install and Close. Okay, so onto NYC DC1. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go into my computer and I'm going to go into my D drive and I'm going to go ahead and create a new folder. Now I want this for my backup, so I'm just going to call this backup target. And then from there, I'm just going to go ahead and share it, and we'll leave the permissions as is. And we're done with that. Okay, back into Server 1. Let's go into our Windows Backup. And from there, we're going to select the backup schedule. Okay, the wizard starts. We're going to do a full server. And we're going to select once a day, and we're going to do this at, let's pick 5 a.m. We'll say next. We want to back up to a shared network folder. Okay, we're going to put in the UNC path of /NYC DC1 backup target, and we're going to say next and provide the credentials needed. So it's going to be the administrator, and we'll put in the administrator's password. Okay, from there we're finished. Okay, we can see it's creating a backup schedule. And the first schedule backup is due to run. I just want to show you how to do it once. So we're going to use the schedule backup options and we're going to hit backup. So now this is going to back up the entire computer and this will take some time. I think it took me in excess of 45 minutes, but we'll pause the video so you can see the end effect. And we're done. So we'll close that. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to mount the VHD backup and we're going to extract information from it. So I'm going to go into Disk Management. And from Disk Management, what I'm going to do is first let's just extend our window. We're going to attach a VHD. And from here, we're going to connect up to our backup. So under Backup Target, we're going to select the backup folder. And from there, we want to select the largest VHD file. There you go, and it's a little shy of 8 gigs. So we'll say OK. And we can see that the VHD file is now being placed on there. Okay, and it's been assigned the drive letter F. Now, if I go into Start, Computer, I've now got the F drive marked on my machine. I can now navigate through this VHD backup and select the information that I want. Okay, from there we'll just detach the VHD and hit OK. Now probably one of the coolest things about VHD backup is I can actually boot from it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into my backup target. I'm going to take my largest VHD and I'm going to copy this and I'm going to paste it into my F drive. Okay, so we just wait for this to copy across and it's done. Now I'm going to go ahead and rename this, and I'm going to call this backup.vhd. And what I'm now going to do is I'm actually going to go into my boot configuration database, and I'm going to point to this backup file. So I'm going to run a command prompt as an administrator, and from there I'm going to go back into the root of my C drive, and then I'm going to use bcdedit copy the current to D from boot from backup. We'll then mark the value of the backup file, and we'll create a new entry where we set the VHD file, and we can see that the operation is completed successfully. Now, to save time, I've copied and pasted the commands from Notepad. And I recommend that you do this. Make sure that you get it right in Notepad, and then you can just paste it into the command prompt. So we're going to paste it in. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to set it. Oh, and we can see that I've got a little typo there. And we'll just paste that last command in. Okay. So we're pointing to the VHD, we're detecting the hardware abstraction layer, and those commands are completed successfully. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to reboot this machine. And what we should see is we now have the backup file as a boot option. So if we go into reboot, we just type in VHD boot test. We'll power cycle the machine, and you can see that we can now select boot from backup. If I hit boot from backup, we'll start Windows normally, and this system will boot directly into that VHD disk, and we can see that this appears to have worked.